In this video, I'll explain the basics of structured logging. Structured logging is a method where all events are logged in the same format, making them easier to analyze and understand. We'll use the Serilog library to implement structured logging in our application. Let's get started. This is a demo web API project. I have also created another web API project with CRUD functionalities. Create, read, update, and delete using entity framework code, which I'll show you after explaining the implementation. You can download the source code from the Patreon post URL in the video description. Let's install the needed libraries from Nuget packages. The first library we need is serilog.asp.net core. Let me install it. Next, we are going to install serilog.syncs.console. Serilog syncs are components that define where log events are sent. Since we need to display the logs in the console window, let's install this library. By including serilog.syncs.debug, we can also display the logs in the debug window. In our project's app settings, you can see the login configuration. Here, the log levels refers to the minimum log level we want to display. You can view the details of log levels on Microsoft's official website. If we set information as the minimum log level, the application will display logs at this level or higher, except for the non-log level. Let's remove these settings now and start implementing Serilog. The builder.host object exposes a useSerilog method that we can use. First, we can set the default minimum log level to information. Then we can override the minimum log level for Microsoft.asp.net core and set it to warning. Now let's specify the syncs to be used. First, we'll write to the debug window where we can provide a custom output template if needed. We'll also write the logs to the console window using the same output template. Instead of providing the configuration here, we can configure it in app settings. Let's see how it is done. In app settings, we should have a configuration key named Serilog. Let's define the minimum log levels first. The default minimum log level is information. Also, let's override the log level for Microsoft.asp.net core and set it to warning. Now, let's define where to write the logs. First, we'll write the logs to the debug window, providing the output template inside arguments. Next, we'll also write the logs to the console window using the same template. In our program class, we can use the useSerilog method with config.readFrom.configuration to provide the configuration object from the context. Let me simplify this to a single line. This approach allows us to make changes by simply modifying the app settings. Now, in the sample controller, let's include some logs. During the execution of this get method, we'll write a log saying request initiated. Then, just before returning the value, we'll write another log with the result. To display the result in proper JSON format, we can use an at symbol here. When running the application, you can now see the logs in both the console and debug windows. I'm going to execute the get method. Here we can see the result in the response body. Let's check the console window. In the console window, you can see the request initiated and request completed logs, but it is only showing one single record in the log. This usually happens when trying to log arrays. Let's change it to a list. Let me execute the method again. Now you can see all the data in the log. To enable request logging, we can use the app.useSerilogRequestLogging method. Now, whenever an API method is called, it will add an additional log that includes the request type, URL, response status code, and the time consumed for execution. This API application with entity framework core CRUD functionalities, which I developed for your reference, will help you understand and implement structured logging in your CRUD APIs. You can get the project source code from the Patreon post link shared in the video description. Let me try the get method first. Since we don't have any products added, we see an empty array in the log. Here, you can see a log right below the request initiated log that displays the database command from EF code. Let's try to create a product. After execution, we can see the logs which include the insert database command. Let me add one more product. The get method now displays the added products. We also have another get method to fetch a product by its ID. The returned result and the request URL are all displayed in the logs. Let's try deleting a product now. In the logs, we can see the deleted product and the request details. We'll be covering more in-depth details of Serilog in our upcoming videos. Don't forget to check out our Patreon page where you can access the CRUD API source code using the Patreon post URL in the video description. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.